She just like stands there and expecting to die. It's fucking idiotic. Overload means to fucking get out of the way.
Okay. The security system is reset. The elevator should be open and I have a PDT.
Excellent. Yes. I can hear the alert. You must be close.
No, I can't.
What's wrong?
The barrier is torn to pieces.
Be vigilant, Hadley. I'm counting on you.
I can do this. Be brave. You can do this. You're doing it.
So that weird being with Samantha. Alright. Thought she'd look more insect-like, but yeah.
Hadley, my dearest little girl, my sweet creature. You're alive.
Do you know me?
Know you? Oh, my girl. I know you better than you know yourself right now.
Oh, God.
Evidence will suffice.
Hadley, you need to go.
No.
And how is the masterpiece inside of you? Healthy, I hope. Growing quickly now, I'm sure. It's nearly time.
What do you mean?
Our baby, Hadley.
Don't talk about my baby. Why did you take me?
You were the right person in the right place at the right time.
Can you help me get out of here?
Trust him.
Out of here? Don't worry about getting out. Security will be here soon. They'll set this all right. Just come. Wait here. This is the safest room in the facility. Here. Closer to me.
I don't think so.
Shit.
Thing out there?
Samantha, a grotesque violation of genetics, but she is locked away. Joseph managed to lure her behind the loading fence. Quite the action hero, our Joseph. He did die rather spectacularly.
The fence has been ripped open, and your experiment is going to tear us all to pieces.
No, no, no. All three of us will be safe very soon. Then we can carry on where we left off.
I said don't talk about my baby.
Let's read this PDA.
I'm afraid that most of that information may be a little above your head.
I'm tempted to stick around just to see this place burn.
Let's read his PDA while he's in the room. Very good. This guy's like the definition of I am very smart. He's a doctor. What the fuck? Maybe it's Dr. Adams in body, but not in the mind. All right.
Hadley, you can't leave me.
Shut up.
Excellent. And I totally knew it was going to do that.
Nothing. I think that's what scares me. The idea that when we die, there's just nothing.
It's not nothing. Sounds like you have a life most are envious of. You have kids, right? A real family. Where people know you exist. Real life. Some of us never got off the starting line.
You will have a family soon.
When I die, I want to leave something behind. You have that. I have student debt and a goldfish.
Your legacy is the child inside of you.
This baby deserves more than what I could ever give. It deserves to be part of something. Something bigger than me. A family. A home. A future. What was I thinking?
Red flag. That was him. Oh, okay. He took the grubs. Ralph is a computer now. It's like a fucking blog.
This room is much smaller than the other.
Maybe he drew the short straw.
This isn't the only small thing he has.
Small dick, so funny.
Voice playback.
Sit back and relax and let the Brosif take you to better place. J-O-S-E-P-H.
Voice imprint accepted. DNA accepted.
Time to see Grublina.
Oh dear. Can you understand me? Do you need, at a loss for words. For this. I don't want to take the phrase bun in the oven too literally.
Thank you.
activity detected in grunt containment habitat.
Well, then finding one of the secrets in the
Chris, do you have any other final words for our
intrepid adventurers?
I would assume they've finished the game if they got this far because the secrets right at the end.
They can carry on taking different secrets.
Bye.
Bye. Well done for finding one of the secrets in Cayne.
Chris, do you have any other final words for our
intrepid adventurers?
I would assume they've finished the game if they got this far because the secrets right at the end.
They can carry on taking different secrets.
Bye.
Bye. Well done for finding one of the secrets in Cayne.
The last thing I said to my son was to get out there and carve his own name into the world and stop relying on mine.
Did you mean it? Sometimes kids know that their parents say things they don't mean. My mom, the last thing she said to me was that I was the reason she was alone. That I sapped the life out of her from the moment I came into existence.
You know that's not true.
A small part of me knows that. A bigger part doesn't.
So they use these little guys to control Samantha. And the gas they give off when they touch dead tissue calms her? I need to catch one!
Yes, we know.
Gotcha. What's your name?
Frederick?
No. Charles. Yeah, you're clearly a Charlie.
Wait. I think one of my sons was named Charlie.
Was?
He died. His mother, she never forgave me. It was my fault. I should have. Protected him.
People die. Sometimes you just can't do anything about it. Well, Charles, I think we're going to go back to Frederick. Right. I'll leave that. Samantha somewhere with Freddy. Maybe I could kill-
Yes. The next conversations I have with my children, it will be different. Second chances at life don't come around often.
Second chances?
Your dad would be proud of you, Hadley.
If he knew me, knew who I had become.
It's Cayne.
Survivor.
It's not my fault that I look like him, or act like him. And it's certainly not this baby's fault. That's on me. I can't blame my child for where I am.
J.B. Joseph Bano.
Okay, Freddy. Time to call Big Mama. Baby is going to be a fighter like his mom. I can feel it.
I know.
Birth is imminent.
It's coming. The baby. The baby is coming.
I'm sorry, Hadley.
Oh, God. It hurts. Something is wrong. There's something wrong.
Nothing is wrong. This is the way
it's time for
you
to die.
Be.
You're talking to the baby. Cayne, rebirthed. I give the game a 7 out of 10. The pacing needs a lot of work because the movement speed and slow dialogue make them pretty much filler. The use of the PDA is fine, but technically it serves as game filler as you're just reading things. The pathfinding in this game is also terrible, where your character doesn't respond to a destination despite spamming clicks, as you can see through the playthrough. Despite all these negatives, the game succeeds in telling a unique story with unpredictable ends. Like, there are a lot of scenes with foreshadowing showing that Cayne is the baby inside her. And even if you find this out in the beginning, the execution remains excellent. And I really enjoyed the funnily realistic office politics with Danny and how people didn't like his antics. And then you also get the useless, lazy, warm body, Ralph, who ends up being the PDT creator, and these are nice touches while following the dark themes throughout the game.